Greetings, fellow Wildlings. Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall as a Mage. We are outside Varus, and despite the fact that I said that we will not be completing any quests until, we will not be touching the mainline quests until we level 5, I feel like we should probably just get this out of the way, combined with the fact that I have like an early day tomorrow. So, yeah, we are here at Varus responding to, what's the name? Yeah. Morgiah summons. Dear strange bird, my eyes and ears abroad say that you are interested in the fate of a certain letter. Any emperor should not be so careless, nor should a queen. You really should come visit me in Castle Varus. I have some interesting tidbits that I'm sure you would enjoy hearing. Morgiah, Princess of Varus. So that's pretty much what we're doing. I also got a horse, and Varus has never looked this beautiful. There are pigeons on top of that thing there. Do you see them? There are little pigeons there, and you can see the crest of Varus. I don't know whether these are the crest or what you call them exactly, but these flags look really pretty. And then there's the rest of the scenery right here, with this man spoiling it, of course. But there's the rest of the scenery right there. Look at the way the terrain just dips down, and there's like the infinite ocean right there. I mean, this is something that I never would have noticed in the original Daggerfall. And made especially beautiful by all these birds flying overhead. Let me just get off my horse for a bit. Admire the scenery. Alright, let's head back then. Time to get on our high horse and travel. So, right. We are supposed to be heading straight north. As far as we can go. We basically have to travel to somewhere in this is the quest where Morgiah tells us to deliver a letter unto, well, another person basically. So that's what we're here to do. Deliver a letter unto another person. Now, I'm not actually identifying any of these buildings here because I frankly do not need the gold. Look at all these people. Because of the mod, it just makes the game that much more lively. And the horse jumps over the fence. Again, something that would have never happened in the original Elder Scrolls. But here we are. Just give me a second there. Time to head in then, and let us hope that the same thing doesn't occur again, at the bug where all of these emperors just disappear, you know. Whew, this place looks beautiful, just look at this place. I am glad that I turned off all that color boost and everything. And Varus is like far more restrictive when it comes to, well, the restrictions they place on you, like far less restrictive. And of course, it also comes installed with the patch where Dark Elves look like Dark Elves. Dunmer, I mean. Because Berenzi is supposed to be a Dunmer, so of course her daughter Morgiah is also a Dunmer. Now, this is the person that we want to talk to. You're trying to track down that letter of the Emperor, yes? Emperors, yes. There are very few scandals in the Bay of which I am totally ignorant. I could give you some information, but nothing is without a price. That I know well. I need a champion who doesn't fear the fire of oblivion. Are you interested? That's selling the mission a little too big, you know? The mission isn't as big as you make it seem. By the Dark Ones, that is a relief to me. Do not ask any questions. Get this letter to a certain high-level sorcerer at the Necromancer's Crypt, Scourg Barrow, in the Dragontail Mountains. Avoid the rift. If you see it, you have gone too far. They will not be expecting you and will not wait for any introductions. The necromancers feel that death is a reward for the living, not a punishment. Once you have delivered the letter, they would feel no need to guarantee your safety. It is their way. I need the letter delivered and a response from the King of Worms in my hand in 1 month from now at the absolute latest. The risks are very high, strange, but please do not fail. If the risks are high, why are you giving it to somebody who... you have no idea whether they'll succeed or not. Rather careless of you, isn't it, Morgiah? Anyhow, let's go ahead and cast teleport right here. Yeah, I'm gonna cast an anchor right here, and glad that these guys aren't triggered by that. Adversary Buckinghouse. This is generic NPCs. This game looks stunning. Whoops, wrong option there. Yes. So, Dragon Tail Mountains, here we come. Dragon Tail Mountains, Dragon Tail right here. Not that far really, but Scourg Barrow. Yes, yes, I do. Actually, I could have done this from the quest log itself, couldn't I? Well, we can take our time getting there and save some money in the process, because we do have like an entire month to ourselves, you know. And here we are, Scourg Barrow. Beautiful. Beautiful as always. Alright, let us equip ourselves with the staff, although we will not be needing it. Because, well... There are no enemies near the entrance. Yeah, I've always been dreadfully curious to see what that thing has, but for now, let me just go ahead and save here in the slot. Actually, should have made a save outside the dungeon, but since I know that this dungeon isn't that bad, it hardly matters. So I want to check out what was down there, and I'll do that on the way back, but the path that we need to take is down there. Alright, let us go ahead and rest until fully healed. Alright. Invisibility and Lumos, because why not? Levitation? Do we really need it? I don't feel like we do. Not for this one anyway. Pretty sure that after this quest is done, we'll also get randomly attacked by a zombie sometime in the future. No. I do wish to take these guys out because... Come here. I'm having that much trouble with only one of them. 12 and Claymore. That's amazing. And a steel staff. Alright. Look at this guy move. My god. Are you fast or are you fast? Why am I missing all my shots? They say you miss all the shots you don't take, but here I am missing all the shots that I am taking. Finally. This one didn't really have much, but this is the door that we need to take. Let's go ahead and save you. Thankfully, they don't really have any skeletons in this... Well, it seems I spoke too soon. There are skeletons in this dungeon. I'll save my mana for the skeletons when the time arrives. I'm not certain if I'm ever going to face them, but you never know, right? Looks like I got bitten by the rat. The bat, rather. And the detection of enemies, like enemies can detect you from way farther in this game. Like in Unity, I mean. It wasn't the case in the original Daggerfall. A Lohomora maybe? Let's try, who knows, because we don't really have anything to fear once inside. Maybe another try. Okay, spell failed, time to bash the door and then. That's pretty much the only thing that we can do. These guys look lovely though. They look far different and they look lovely. What the fuck was that? That is an ancient lich. Better not disturb that thing then. And that's a vampire ancient. What company do you keep there, King of Worms? There's another ancient lich back there. And the way you know that they're not actually, you know, interested in you is, well, they sort of face away when you move towards them. Look at them. They face away when you move towards them, indicating that they do not want to attack you. But at any rate, let's go ahead and talk to this guy then. Very good. If you're not rewarded with death by the loyal servants of the Barrow, please give this note to Princess Morgiah, please. Please. Saving there because I hear some people moving towards me. Even though literally every single creature in here can see me. Despite me being invisible, because that's the way they're programmed. But here we go. Retracing our steps back upstairs. And actually we don't really need to do all that. We can just teleport back home. But I am sort of curious to check out what's there on the under the, you know, other thing. The other casket there. So with that in mind, I will actually go ahead and check it out. I hear another zombie somewhere. I think there was like a hidden door somewhere there that we could have used to get to that zombie. And this, for whatever reason, I don't know why they made it like this, but maybe just developer insight, but yeah. Oh yeah, I think if you grab this, it casts a levitate spell on me. Yeah, so let's try jumping down here and seeing what the fuck. Nothing but like a couple of mummies there. Okay, right. Well, with that having been done, let's recast our own teleport spell and get out of here, because this seems to be an ambush chamber. Yeah, no longer want to remain there. Alright, time to teleport to... others. Frames, come back please. Yeah, thank you. For whatever reason, coincidentally, our Nox spell also disappeared, so let us go ahead and talk to Princess Morgiah. I do not want to grab her, I do want to talk to her though. It's done. I'll be Queen of Firsthold, although I'm not sure the engagement will be quite lengthy. Now, I promise you information about the Emperor's letter. The letter you seek is in the hands of Godfork, the Warlord of the Orcs. He bought it from the Thieves Guild of Daggerfall after one of the numbers stole it from Queen Obiki. I confess I don't know why the Emperor sent it to Obiki. The girl is innocent to a fault, and everyone knows that Gothred is not the loyal Empire today. Or rather, Emperor, I don't really know. That Lysandus was. Of course, my own family. Well, enough of this boring gold gossip, she says while catching herself in the act. If you really want to find this letter, you should get in good with Minnesota, the former Queen of Daggerfall and Queen Mother to Gothred. I wouldn't directly approach her. Start with someone of lower station. A bracer. Oh yeah, she does like reward you with a random item as well. It's supposed to be magical, but I guess I do not have enough magical abilities yet. Look at me, I'm floating in your dungeon. I mean, I'm pretty sure that if I do this even in Daggerfall, they won't be able to find any fault with it. Primarily because of how... well... how do I put this? I didn't explicitly cast this magic inside the walls, so... to be honest. Oh, it's nighttime. Interesting. Well, that brings us to the end of this video then. The next time we come back, we will see each other in... well, I don't know if we will see each other. I was hoping it will be the Elysian Hills, but yeah, pretty much the Elysian Hills. I've got no rush to bring this journey to an end. Daggerfall is one of those games that you take slow. I Oh, I cannot change my transport mode right now. Probably because I'm levitating. I thought it would be interesting to see how you could float with a horse. Just look at the beauty of this place. Daggerfall. Especially the Unity version, my god. It just looks serene. Anyhow, that is the end of today's video. We came to, you know, respond to Morgiah's summons. She in turn gave us some information that we were looking for, and that in turn helped us out. And just look at all these buildings with their lit windows. It just looks so pretty right now. I hear a horse. There's the horse. Maybe I should cast this. Okay, it does make a difference. It does make a little bit of a difference, yes. Especially for when you're trying to see something that's close to you. A young lad with the rose of beads embroidered on his surcoat appears at your side, hands you an engraved card and disappears. So I basically had to... I'm back in Elysian Hills right now. And even this place looks quite pretty, to be honest, with its emblems and everything. And the undulating terrain. I wish Unity... Sorry, the original Daggerfall could capture all of this, but then again... Oh, Elysian Hills. All plague victims must be left in the street to be gathered and burned. Theodored, I think. That's sad. But, yeah, I just got that letter and it's pretty much... an invitation. King Edvir and Queen Berenice, sovereigns of the Kingdom of Vedas, are proud to announce the engagement of Morgiah, Princess of Vedas, to Garodil, King of Firsthold, in the Isle of Somerset. So, I sort of forgot to mention this, but that letter that we helped deliver to the King of Worms, it was essentially a deal that Morgiah had made. She had basically instructed the King of, the King of Worms, the King of the Necromancers, to essentially help this guy, Garodil, yeah, be able to talk to his dead son, and in exchange for that, he's like, this Garodil person is so extremely afflicted by whatever happened to his son that he is willing to make a deal with the devil, or go to any lengths for that matter, to actually talk to him. So he agrees to marry Morgiah, and Morgiah of course has some or the other kind of favor ready, or maybe she already has completed favor for the King of Worms. They seem to be pals anyway. So yeah, that essentially she politically maneuvered her way into the court of Somerset Isle, into one of the courts of Somerset Isle, and that's basically in Morrowind. Is it in Morrowind? Huh. No, Somerset Isles, that's like the Dominion of the Altmer. Morrowind is the Dominion of the Dunmer with the Dark Elves. So yeah, she basically found a place in the court of the High Elves, or the Light Elves, whatever you would like to call them. So that's essentially what this context is. The reply that the King of Worms gives is a pretty short one. It's done. As simple as that. And yeah, that's the end of that. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for sticking around until the end. Until next time, take care. Pretty well, fellow. Thanks.